What's up, y'all? Welcome back to my channel. So your girl been busy today. I went to work and I also went to Target and I have a 60 second haul for y'all. Count it, okay? 60 seconds. I got a couple of little items because I was fancy, okay? Actually, I had a gift card. My job was wonderful to me. They wanted to thank me, and it's a team effort, you know, and it's nothing like having good company morale, and they praise you and let you know you're doing a good job. And they gave us a $100 gift card to Target. So I did a little grocery shopping. I wanted to share with y'all. And then we're going to get into story time because I haven't told a story in a minute. And this one, grab some wine. You're going to want to hear about this one. So I went to Target, got a little haul for y'all. We got tissue in the back. We got some detergent. We got some platinum cascade. Some organic tampons that my daughter swore by. I don't use those. I use the old school pads, okay? Got some Simply Lemonade back there. Some toaster strudels because we fancy as fuck around this bitch. Some wieners for your beaners. Cold Stone Creamery. Some Harvarti. Cheese, some schmoot jams, some frozen vegetables. I've never tried the cornbread pie or the shepherd's pie. Okay, it says a chicken and bacon. And some Intamin mini pie, some mini rice, some cinnamon toast crunch, some bread, and there is a little hot doggy bun. Boom, Target haul completed in 60 seconds. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my video. Thank you, like, really, thank you for stopping by. If this is your first time, subscribe to me. I don't know what side it's on, either here or there. Hit the subscribe button, keep in touch so you can catch a video when I drop one. As I said earlier, it's a story time. Do you have your wine? What do you have? What are you drinking on? Comment below what we're drinking on right now. Chocolate milk, wine, Patron, Hennessy's, Kahlua, Bailey's, Roscato. What we got in our drink? Because we finna have a little discussion. Actually, this discussion, some of you are going to be like, what? And some of y'all that already know, going to be like, girl, you did that. So today we're going to talk about one of the craziest jobs I ever had that I did not even know was really a real job. And I'll explain it as we go. Of course, once I get on camera, I start dehydrating. Like, seriously? So, I was a phone sex operator. Yes. For about 2 years. Am I out of focus? Stop that. For about 2 years, I worked as a phone sex operator from the comfort of my home, and yeah, I got paid. I did. So we're just going to briefly go into this story time as to how it was, what the job consisted of, and the whole nine. So how I ended up doing phone sex operator was I was working in a nursing home, or was I a Burger King? I can't remember. It was my daughter's 17. So it was well over 17 years ago.
Because she was little.
Y'all, let me tell you. This ring light, I can't. It just takes me out. And the thing of it is, the ring light sits over where the camera is. So you want to look at the camera in order to look at you guys. If I look here, I'm looking at me. And I'm always working on that, looking at the camera, but the ring light is there. And yeah, so it's telling me to close my eyes and go to sleep. So anywho, I was working either at Burger King or I was a CNA, but I know I needed an extra job. But I wanted a part-time job, but I didn't want to physically go to a job. I was having some trouble looking for some at-home work. Didn't really know where to look. Because 17 years ago, working at home wasn't really as popular as it is now. And I was watching TV and a commercial popped up that was a phone sex operator. And the girl or the commercial was like, "Operate girls, hot girls are waiting now." And I'm like, oh my God, do people really call those things? So I was under the impression that they were, oh, y'all know I'm on a lipstick journey. This is the lipstick I have on. It's purple. It's straight up purple. Okay. It's not a matte. So, I'm learning lipsticks. I'm learning. I'm determined to wear lipstick. But anywho, I was already online. I just Googled how to become a phone sex operator. On a whim, playing, and many, many, many job sites popped up. I was like, apply here. What? I'm like, these aren't recordings. I was under the legit impression that phone sex operator work was a little 5-minute recording. You know, it was a pre-recorded call. The guy sat and listened to a woman breathe heavily, and they paid money, $4, $5 by the minute. So, and there probably is jobs like that. But it's actually people that sit on the other end of the phone, dressed in their pajamas like I was, okay, talking nasty for a living. So I said, you know what? I'm going to apply. I mean, what? What could happen? Put my name in, applied. They called me, y'all, in less than an hour. I was like, hello? She like, yeah, you put an application in. I can't remember the company either. If I can get into my Yahoo account, which is probably full of porn spam, I'm going to try to find that email. Yeah, because I haven't used my Yahoo in well over probably 17 years. So, anywho.
Excuse me.
Give me, Satan, go fix it, Jesus, with all this yarning. So, I fill out the application. Like I said, she called me about an hour. She was like, we're looking for operators. You can work any shift you want in intervals of 4 hours. And you can work up to 40 hours or as minimal as 4 hours. If you decide to log on, you have to do 4 hours. And after that, you're not committed to do any more unless you choose to. I'm like, this a job? Oh, I'm going to work. She was like, yeah, you finna go to work. She was like, no cell phones, and you got to go buy your headset, and you need the internet, grounded internet, not Wi-Fi. I was like, oh, okay. So I got my headset. I had my internet. They sent me to what was called adult school. So for 2 weeks, it was online, and you basically listen to them teach you how to talk. Because you think it's just, you know, because when she asked me, have I ever did phone sex before? I was like, no, but I talk nasty to my dude all the time. You know, she was like, no, it's not like that. I'm like, what? You know, what's more nastier than I'm about to ride your face? I mean, come eat this vagina. I mean, that's probably still prim and proper, but she was like, no. She was like, we'll give you some training and we'll show you how to make sound effects. And I'm like, sound effects? She was like, yeah, you got to make it wet. You got to know how to spank it. I'm like, oh, this a job. I'm like, this a job. I was still in awe like this was a job. So I did that training for 2 weeks. And she said, just so you know, and we're not even being funny, but Caucasian sounding voice women get more calls, and it's just what it is. She was like, black girl voices, their characters are called more under the specialties because the men that fetishize BBWs or just want a BBW fantasy will call for the black girls. And I was like, really? She was like, yeah. She was like, the whiter you sound, the better. And I can sometimes tell, like, you give me 10 calls, I'm going to know 8 of y'all, either white or black. It's just, you just know. Comment below if you think I'm right or wrong. Can you tell sometime by the way a person talk if they're white or black? I mean, we know if you got an accent, you could be Arabic or what have you. But sometimes you can't. But she was just telling me how to get my money. She was like, try to make your voice sound as white as you can. And the categories were things like barely legal, That's a, this 18. And oh, the rules were no bestiality, no incest, of course, no pedophilia, no children. Barely legal to me was stretching a little bit because you were 18, but the role was supposed to be you just turned 18. Like, you just had a birthday, and I was supposed to be a part of your dialogue. I didn't really feel that because I'm not 18. And when I did this, even though it was 17 years ago, I wasn't 18. But I did the dominatrix. I did that role. I did anything that was BBW. So it might have been BBW getting bent over the pinto beans and stuffed with an andouille sausage. Okay, that's where we are right there. So I had a lot of the specialty calls, and I did a lot of the dominatrix. It's easy as it seemed, like you just talking nasty. It's different when it's broad daylight, because I worked in the daytime when I wasn't at my other job, and especially when my kids were at school. Oh, because that was a rule too. You can't have your children walking around your house, or even if you're in your bedroom, they can't open the door like, "Mom, I want a cookie." And you in the middle of getting a guy off, so it couldn't be no kids in the house. That was in your contract as well. No children in the house. And if you're on the phone with a guy and you hear a child come in the background, you had to disconnect the call immediately. However, they said if another person come in the room, it could be the wife, the girlfriend, even if they end up cussing that person out, you are not supposed to hang up the phone because every minute counts. So if he got the phone in his hand, like he might have threw it, and he arguing with the wife or anything, it's until it hang up, you let it rock out. I'm like, so I'm like, ain't nobody gonna do that. Let me tell you, those were some of my most funniest calls when the girlfriend, who you in there talking to? Dang, baby, nobody. I'm just on the toilet. You like, really? You been on the toilet this whole time? Or they in the bed. Man, I was texting my boy. They got every excuse. Those were funny. Or when they get finished, I just felt like it's rude to finish. And then click, like, hello, you don't want to cyber cuddle, you gotta just leave, you'll just hang up on me. The guys would come, I'm talking about, they got all to come, like, oh, you know, they going at it, oh yes, bitch, fuck. I mean, they doing the most, and soon as that last drop, a nut leave their body, dial tone click, you be like, hello, I feel so used. So the calls ended abruptly every single time if you engaged in phone sex. If you just had a conversation, because a lot of them were just lonely and wanted to talk. I had a guy that talked to me strictly about Demi Moore's breasts. One, I didn't know the girl had breast implants. Now, mind you, again, this was 17 years ago, so I don't know I never Googled it or looked it up just to see if she really had them. I don't know, but he was upset about it. And he was like, what size are your breasts? And I knew I had to think quick on my feet. I'm like, A, 32, I mean, 24, whatever. I said it was a small number. He was like, those are so precious. They're so precious. Don't ever get them big. You promise? I'm like, no. And I'm up here with 44 double Ds and shit. I'm like, no, I'll never do that. It was like, it was just a waste of her money. She did too much. I can never look. I mean, he talked to me for 15 minutes about that woman. And I was right there with him, like, shame on her. You know, why would she do that? Whatever your fantasy conversation is, honey, I was delivering. I had a guy who wanted me to beat him and stump his balls. Thankfully, it was just imagination. Stump his balls. He wanted to be cussed out. And one man was crying, like, when he started to orgasm from being beat, he was crying. I was like, is he crying or is he acting? What are we doing? Couple of times I got rolled up. How do you get rolled up on a phone sex job? Because I giggled. I giggled and the guy hung up. So that was inappropriate. It wasn't inappropriate. It was not respecting the customer. You're not supposed to shame them by laughing. And some of the shit was funny. But I did that for 2 years. And actually, it was one of the most mentally draining jobs ever. Because some things I didn't want to hear. You know, it's only... And I'm a very sexual person. Love, love, love it. I love the whole art of sex. I love I love it. I love it. I love it. But, I mean, I can't talk about it every day. Like, I can harass my dude every day just on some playfulness, but a whole conversation. Like, you got to think of these fantasies, you know, and they give you, like, a little script, but it's their fantasy. So, if they want you tied up, and they want to, they want you, it's just too much. And the visual of it sometimes lingers on after the call is over. I'm just like, enough. So how much was my pay? I got paid $12 an hour, cash. So they gave me a 1099. And the checks went out every 2 weeks. Got paid every 2 weeks. However, because where were they located? California? I don't remember, but one check, every time I got paid, it was like I was getting paid once a month. Because one check took almost 2 weeks to get to me. No direct deposit was available back then. And sometimes 3 weeks. But I would still get two checks dated for that month. They just, the mail carrier. I was averaging $300 to $400 a week, just talking dirty, just phone sex. I did it for almost 2 years, and it was, like I said, mentally exhausting, like, oh, God, I don't want to, you know, and some of the conversations, like I said, lingered on. You would think about it throughout the day. I'm like, ugh, you know, yeah, that's about it. So that is my one job that I'm like, no. Now, let me tell you what I would be interested in if I go do my research and find it. The texting one. They have where you just chat. It's on their website. And you're texting their cell phone, but it's from within their website. And I forgot what it's called. But those are kind of hard to get in. Again, I'm going to say, speaking from 17 years ago, they were hard to get in because those were like super easy. You just sat and text all day. Don't nobody really quit those. The phone sex operator, the verbal, the actual talking, high turnover, because it just mentally just wears you out. So if you have questions below, feel free to comment. What's your thoughts? Could you do it? Let's see. Could you do it? What are your thoughts on my story? Yeah. And I'm going to be honest. I'm not here for that's immoral. It's wrong, honey, sirs. it wasn't, anything illegal or immoral about talking about sex. It's not. So, I mean, you can have your opinion on it, but it's not. Sex is part of life. Whether you get some or you don't, it is what it is. Okay, yeah, I'm out of here. Goodbye. Thank you for listening to my story time. I will be back with another video.